Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammāsambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammāsambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammāsambuddhassa. Thank you. And this afternoon, we would like to encourage to all of you again for the practice of meditation to be continuous. Not only in this retreat, after going home, also I want you to practice continuously every day, the daily practice.
那在这一次的禅，这个开示呢，禅师想要就是鼓励每个人能够持续的在打坐，回到家里也是希望说可以每天都打坐。
In the last session, I came in and looked at all of your face. Many people have very good sitting and also very good concentration, but a few people have been sleepy.
那在打坐的时候呢，禅师有进来看看这每个人的样子，那觉得说大家做得很好，因为这个专注的也很好，可是还有几个人在有点昏沉。
Then in my mind, the thought that, oh, if this way, if they can meditate 5 or 6 days, sure, if you can continuously practice for 5 or 6 days, sure, you always get jhāna and deep concentration. No?
当时禅师的心里面想说，如果他们可以持续这样的用功5到6天，那一定有人可以进入禅那，能够得到很深的这个定力。
So next year, please come and meditate here for 10 days retreat. Shiva, you will get jhāna.
所以明年呢，请各位一定要来这里打坐禅修10天，那我们一定可以进入禅那。好不好？
Very good. And also, parallel is all the organizers have done very well, very supportive. I could see that everybody in helping different ways. And also all the Vande here and all the Vashi very kindly support us. That is very good. And a very nice place, very quiet. This environment is very important for Anapanasati. The place need to be quiet, the mind need to be quiet. And all the support and everything is perfect. That's why your mind can settle and you can concentrate to the object without problems. You know? And also everybody having very quiet, not in and out, you know. If many people have been moving and disturbing to each other, they also disturb for your concentration and meditation. That's why we have metta to support each other. Even you want to move also, oh, I try not to move so much. Because I'm moving too much, maybe disturb for my beside, my neighbor. There is understanding and metta to each other. That's why the room is without movement. You can see the quiet feeling and the energy also very good.
那还有就是也非常感谢所有的主办，那这次的活动呢，非常安排的非常好。那所有的法工呢，义工都用他们不同的方式在护持这次的道场。那常住的所有法师也非常的。 也帮助我们很多。那这个地方很好，很静，所以这个静的地方呢，这个环境呢，对于我们修观呼吸是很重要的。它能够让我们的心和这个环境都静下来，所有的因缘都具足的时候，我们就能够把我们的心稳定下来，让我们的心能够专注。 那在这里呢，禅师观察到说，每个人都很静，没有人就是一直走进走出，因为说当我们移动太多的话，可能会干扰到其他人的专注。那所以说，我们是用这个慈心的力量护持彼此的修行，所以我们心里面在想说，我不要动得太多，怕干扰到旁边坐的人，所以我们彼此之间呢，都有这个慈心，有这个互相的体谅。 所以才能够感觉到说这整个厅里面呢是没有是很静的，有非常好的这个能量，完全没有人在动。
Okay, And also we need to check our mind. My mind is really with the meditation object or not. This afternoon, after listening, you need to check, oh, today I have done good things. When I meditate, how long can I concentrate on the breath object? My mind really awareness on the breathing or with other objects? And with other objects, not easy to get concentration. You are not really control your mind. You don't have enough mindfulness. That's why next time we have to train our mind not to follow any idea and the thought. I just want to be with meditation object. In this way, we train again, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, slowly our mind can have ability. Our mind, we can control our mind. Once we can control your mind, that concentration is very easy.
So we can also check our own heart. My heart is really with the meditation object. Then we listen to it, we can say, I'm doing a very good thing. Then my meditation condition is how? Can I focus on breathing for how long? My heart is with breathing, or my heart has already taken other goals? If our heart and other goals are together, then we need to have a decision. It's not easy. Because we don't control our own heart, our intention is not enough, so we need to train our heart, so that our heart will not raise any thoughts, any ideas, simply just focus on the benefits of practice. That gradually our heart will have strength, my heart will be able to control it, and we will be able to cultivate
stability. Okay, once you get the concentration, the mind slowly starts to be happy with the breath object. The body becomes very light and very comfortable. This is the sign of concentration at the beginning.
当我们的心开始静下来，有定力的时候，我们的心呢，渐渐的会感到快乐，我们的身体也会感觉到非常的轻安，非常的舒服。那这就表示说呢，我们的定力在增强了。
Do you feel happy with the breath, not just not the sitting?
刚才在打坐的时候，你感觉专注呼吸快乐吗？
Behind, 后面呢？
后面的人呢？
Yeah. 快乐吗？ Wow, that is 很重要, okay? Very important, huh? When you concentrate on the Dhamma object, breathing in Dhamma object, on the Dhamma object, you are willing, want to watch the breath, you are happy, you can feel the happy feeling from that looking at the Dhamma object. One second, you are really concentrated on the breath. You have so many good karma when the mind thought of process. So 1 hour you concentrate on the breathing, you have so many million of wholesome karma today you have done. No?
当我们专注在呼吸，那这就是在专注在法，呼吸就是这个法的目标。那当我们看着呼吸，感觉到快乐的时候，如果有一秒钟的时间，我们能够专注，那就已经造下了很多的这个善业。就是当我们的一门心路过程升起的时候，那假如说我们专注呼吸一个小时，那我们所升起的这个善业，这个善业呢，是好多亿的。
Next time you can come again for the meditation retreat, the time we will explain how to practice anti jhana, okay? Once you get a jhana, we can practice anti four jhana deep concentration. Based on this deep concentration, we also the next step we practice vipassana. Vipassana means inside knowledge. We need to analyze the nature of our body, the nature of our inside. That is what we call vipassana. So we need to practice vipassana. Why we need to practice? We want to get right understanding, right view. That is for the wisdom. No? In the Noble Eightfold Path, I hope that you can remember. This morning I did explain Sila, Samadhi, and Panya. Morality, concentration, and Vipassana inside. For the wisdom, we need to practice Vipassana.
所以希望说，如果说大家可以再回来的话，禅师能够解释呢，下一次能够解释说我们要怎么样修才能够进入禅那。那禅那呢，最后也可以进到四禅。四禅是非常深的这个定力。那当我们有了很强很深的这个定力过后，下一步呢，就是我们能够修观禅。那观禅呢，就是让我们专注在我们身体的内在，我们身体里面的这些性质。 那我们就能够修这个观禅。那为什么我们要修观禅呢？因为我们想要升起正见， 正见和正确的一种理解，让我们的智慧能够升起。那刚才讲到的八正道当中呢，就包括了戒定而慧，而慧主的这个修行呢，就是透过观禅的修行。
Penetrating inside of our body, this morning we did explain roughly we need to know 32 part of body truly, internally and externally. Then on this 32 part of body, we need to break down by four element meditation. In the end, ultimate reality, you can see many particles are joined together in this every organs.
当我们专注在渗透到我们的身体里面的时候，就能够知道说我们的体内有32身分。那我们必须要知道内在和外在的32身分。那这个32身分呢，我在接下来我们必须要用这个世界分别观的方法把它给破解、破开，成为究竟色法，能够看到呢，它是由很多的微小粒子组成的。
Why we need to break down into particles and this small piece? If not, we always think that this is my eyes, my ear, my nose, my tongue. Mm-hmm.
为什么说我们必须要把它能够破解成为很多的微小粒子呢？因为我们老是想着说，这是我的眼睛、我的耳朵、我的鼻子。
It is true. Yeah. Do you love your eyes? Do you?
你爱你的眼睛吗?
Please answer. Do you love your eyes? Yeah. How about your hair?
你的头发呢? 爱你的头发吗?
Yeah. 32 part of body, the hair, the body hair, the skin, you know, the muscle, everything, organs, different parts. Attachment. I love my hair, you know. And so you want to change different color every time, no? Design, different design, because you want to make a beautiful design. Spend so much time and money for that beauty, no? For the hair.
那我们的32身分也包括了我们的头发、我们身体上的体毛、皮肤，或者是很多其他的这个部分。那我们对这些都有很大的执着。 那比如说我们爱我们的头发，所以老是呢想要改变它的颜色，或者是改变呢这个发型，那以为说这样做我们会变得很美，那因为这样子我们花了很多钱很多时间。So
you love your hair very much, okay? Cannot tell lie. If you don't, who don't like the hair? We are don't like it, sir. We cut and shave very dirty. We feel that there's 32 part of body, a repulses in our body. Not nice, okay? We don't want cut attachment. That, because we don't wear hair, we don't need to spend money. We don't need to spend the time for the hair. Save time and energy.
那我们都是爱头发的，那我们也不能够打妄语。只有说呢，像禅师，他是不喜欢头发的，因为说觉得这个头发很脏，他就是我的32身分是很可厌的，他不想要这个头发，所以用这个方式也可以断除对头发的执着。那不想要它，那因为这样子呢，也不用花钱花时间在头发上，那可以省时间，也可以省钱。
I agree with my idea.
你同意禅师的想法吗？
So this evening, who want to shave, please come. Free of charge, no need to pay. I will shave for you, okay? Then I will be very happy. Oh, after my talk, they have right understanding. They get a Dharma knowledge. No, they don't want the hair, no? That's good.
那如果同意的话，今天傍晚呢，禅师说，如果你想要剃头的话，那请你来找禅师，他会免费的能够帮你呢把头发剃掉。那禅师将会感到非常的快乐，想说，哦，原来我开示过后，他们升起了正见，他们有法了，现在已经不要他们的头发了，好不好？No
answer. Yeah, now you love, you think that good. Your husband say, oh, your hair is so beautiful, so nice color, you know. So tomorrow you try, you pull out the few hair and put on the plate where he want to eat the food. So you put beside. He really love your hair or not? And also yourself, you see that once removed from your hair, you still like it or not, you know?
那我们很爱，觉得这是很好的。那我们的丈夫也说，啊，你的头发很好，这个颜色很美。那明天我们就试试看，把几根头发拔出来，那就放在他要吃饭的这个盘子旁边，然后放在看看他还喜欢你的头发吗？那我们自己看了，每一当这个头发从我们的头上拔下来的时候，我们是还爱他吗？
Great man, how about the nose, ear? Want to make it beautiful? No, skin.
还有说我们的鼻子，我们的耳朵，我们想要把它们弄得很美。还有我们的皮肤也是一样。
Every time you know, you like to follow in the modern day, okay, the latest design. Which one is popular in America? You like to follow American design.
那我们都喜欢跟着最新的潮流、最新的款式。那看说美国现在最流行的是什么样的，那我们也想跟着。对吗
？Even face also like to do surgery for V shape nowadays. Many places I saw that spend money and dangerous also like to do for beauty.
那连我们自己的脸型呢，都想要去整一整容，那想要把它的这个形状改变一下。那很多地方呢，禅师都能够看到，很多人都喜欢这样子做。那它又昂贵，可是也对自己有危险。可是有很多国家都有人这么做。So
many Chinese believe, ancient time, no, long time ago, they had to believe that your face need to be round, need muscle, full, then only you will get money. Understand? That is our traditional belief. You don't care now, okay? I just want to be beautiful. So you go and make it. So we follow your sign. You get a beauty, but your money will lost. The sign is important also, you know?
那以前呢，这个在传统当中，华人的这个信仰，就相信说，我们的这个脸部，如果是圆的，有比较有肌肉，或者是比较丰满的话，那我们将会是富裕的人。那我们明白吗？可是这是传统的信仰，可是现在我们不在乎这种信仰了，我们想要美貌，把这个形状改变了，可是到最后呢，我们连这个钱财我们都失去了。Okay,
you want money or you want beauty?
所以你是要想你想拥有这个福相，还是你想要漂亮呢？
There is sometimes just for understanding change of nature nowadays. Okay, so even traditional belief also sometimes not used. No?
所以禅师这样的比喻呢，是让我们理解，就是现在呢，我们的这个思想已经改变了。那虽然说以前传统的信仰是这样子，可是到现在呢，可能我们已经不采取传统的这种信仰了。So
everybody attachment on their body, their skin, they have to do all the organs also the same attachment. That's why the Buddha encouraged us to practice. Don't think that it is your eyes. Do your polymer and different particles. When you see what all the particle is arising and passing, in the end you don't see eyeball, you don't see ear, you don't see all the organs. All are arising and passing of the nature of impermanent suffering, non-self, movement only.
所以我们非常的执着我们的身体、我们的肌肤、我们的器官。那佛陀就鼓励我们说，不要想说这是我的眼睛，我们用世界分别观能够看到很多微小粒子一直的在生灭。所以到最后呢，根本没有眼球，我们的耳朵、我们的器官也能够看到，他们只是很多微小粒子一直的在生灭，而且他们是无常、苦、无我，一直的在变动的。Okay.
Our mind also the same, not only rupa, the nature of rupa, and you know that everybody, me and yourself, and everybody, you look at that, everybody is impermanent, suffering, non-self of particles. As well, the mind, thought process, we have thought process. After your eyes contact with external object, we have eyes consciousness, ear consciousness. After that, the mind, thought process is arising. Sometimes, you after contact, your intention is good, your contemplating is good, then you will get wholesome mind. Kusala, wholesome mind. Sometimes your intention is not good, you don't feel good, you will get akusala, unwholesome mind.
所以我们的这个心也是同样的，不只是在色法方面。那我们看的有我有你，那我们是。 这样子的看到，不过其实呢，我们都是无常苦我的。尤其当我们看到一门心路过程的时候，比如说当我们的眼睛接触到目标过后，我们会升起眼识；那耳朵接触过后会升起耳识；那过后呢，一门心路过程会升起。所以在接触过后，如果说我们开始的动机是好的，那我们就能够升起这个善的心；如果说我们开始的这个动机是不好的，我们就会升起不善心。
Okay, we also need to understand the nature of our mind also, how the mind moves very fast, come and go, arising and passing away. The nature of the mind also impermanent, suffering, nonsense. Who understand about the mind and the matter, the nature of the mind and body, then only the person really understand the truth of the suffering, the wisdom arises. No?
当我们能够了解到这个心的性质的时候，那就能够看到这个心念呢，它也是一直来来去去，一直的在生灭，它也是无常苦无我的。那凡是能够了解到生心的这个性质的人，就能够理解到苦地，那我们的智慧也会升起了。Because
of that wisdom, you know that in our body impermanence, there is not mine, not my eyes, not my body. Can let go about understanding of who I am, my belong to me. All kinds of wrong understanding can release. Right understanding, this is not mine, not belong to me, not myself. That's right understanding.
那因为说我们的智慧升起，在我们的身体里面呢，我们没有办法看到说这是我的，或者这是我的身体。 那我是谁？这些是属于我的，这些种种的一些错误的理解呢？这些邪见呢？我们都能够把它断除。到最后呢，就我们能够看到说，没有我，没有属于我的，也没有我的一个个体。Can
you accept it? People tell you that it is not your husband, that is not your wife, not your children, that is rupa kalpa only. Can you accept it or not?
如果说有人告诉你说，这不是你的丈夫，这不是你的妻子，这也不是你的孩子，他们只是色聚而已，你能够接受吗？
明白吗？ Can you accept or cannot accept?
你可以接受吗？还是不能够接受呢？
Oh yeah. Now, although you understand can't let go in the mind, they think that it is my wife belong to me, my husband belong to me, cannot go with anybody. It's only for me, myself, for my group, my family. You know? This way, that thinking and understanding in the Buddha explained that it's wrong understanding because of attachment and who I am, who she is. There is wrong view and wrong understanding. You know?
所以这是不容易的，我们虽然说我们了解，可是我们没有办法放下，老是想着说这是我的妻子、我的丈夫、这是我的孩子，他们是属于我的，他不能够和他跟其他人在一起，他是为了我、为了我这一群人、为了我的家人，所以这些呢都是邪见，这些邪见呢都是因为执着，想说我是谁，或者是他是谁，他是我的谁。
And also not easy to let go. You think they all are belong to me. No?
那我们也没有，也不能够轻易的放下，我们就觉得说这些都是属于我的。对吗？
Other people ask you, oh, please offer your clothes, very beautiful. Other donation, easier for you to let go, you can turn out easily. When people ask you, please offer your wife, your husband, your children, not easy.
那假如说有人告诉我们说呢，哦，你这件衣服非常的美，请你供养给我。那我们能够布施，这可能比较容易。那如果有人告诉你说，请你把你的妻子、你的丈夫或者是你的孩子送给我，那这件事就比较困难了。可以吗？
Cannot tell lie, okay?
那可以吗？同样的，不能够打妄语哦。
Okay, bodhisattva have to dana. For the bodhisattva, no? Must give it away. Even your life, your organs. Even ask you, if you want to be a bodhisattva, have to give away. Cannot say after die, you know?
如果说是菩萨的话呢，这样就一定要布施，连我们的生命有人要，我们也要能够送出去。我们的器官也一样。如果我们想要成菩萨的话，我们就要把它给出去，要不然呢就没有办法修这个菩萨行。
That is highest practice for the bodhisattva. No? We need to do that.
那在修菩萨行呢，这当中这是最崇高的一种修行。
Why you cannot offer your wife, your children, and your husband? No?
为什么说我们没有办法供养出我们的妻子、我们的丈夫或者是孩子呢？
You love. You don't want to separate. Who love your lover, who you love, you always want to be together. Cannot stay together, you will be suffering. Separation of beloved, that is suffering, the Buddha said. You have to associate with enemy, that is also suffering. That is the Buddha explained in dependent origination.
那是因为爱，所以我们不想要和他们分开。那因为我们爱他们呢，和自己爱的人，我们想要和他在一起。如果说没有办法在一起的时候，我们就会非常的痛苦。所以这就是呢，就是没有办法和自己所爱的人升起的痛苦。那和我们所不喜欢的人，我们的敌人在一起的时候，我们也会很苦。那这是在佛陀呢，他在教这个缘起法的时候解释的。对吗？
Yeah, but your love also impermanence, not
for permanence.
Who you love his body and the mind, okay?
那你所爱的人呢, 你爱的是他的身体和他的心。
对吗? 对不对? 不可以睡啊。 Okay. Okay. Think carefully, okay? When she died or he died, are you okay with that body or not after a few days of dying? No?
那我们现在要想清楚，比如说当他死后呢，他的这个身体，他的死后几天后的这个身体，我们还可以吗？我们还要吗？
你可以爱继续吗? Can you love continuously or not that body?
你还可以继续的爱他的身体爱下去吗？
So now no, you say that. So if you really love, you have to love continuously, even his body in that after the changing and the skeleton. No?
那我们回答不可以。可是如果说我们是真的爱，那我们的爱应该是持续下去的。他死后呢，他的身体，无论他的身体怎么样的变化，或者到最后变成一副骨头，也是一样。
After 6 months, and then you can, when you go back, you can ask your husband or your wife, after I die, let me stay 1 month at home, my dead body at home. Are they okay or not? They will tell you yes or no.
当我们回家的时候，能够问我们的丈夫或者是我们的妻子，我死后，我想要你呢，把我的尸体留在家里一个月，可以吗？
Then you can see, before you die, when you are sick, very seriously sick, they will tell, oh, we don't want you to go away. We want to be together with you. Please don't go away. So you believe that what your family say, okay? Oh, they love me. They really want me to be with them. So I don't want to go anywhere. After I die, I want to be with my family. Many people had that problem. So because you had attachment in the family before you die, the last moment, after you die, you become the ghost, or hungry ghost, or no? That's what happened at home.
所以在我们死前呢，当我们生病的时候，家人就会告诉我们说，我们不想要你走，我们想要你和我们在一起。那你相信他们想说他们爱我，他们想要我和他们在一起，所以我什么地方都不要去，我只想要和我的家人在一起。那很多人都有这个问题，所以因为这个执着呢，在死后呢，他们就投胎成为这个恶鬼，这个鬼，而且在家里。
Okay, so when you become the ghost, you can see the whole family, but the whole family cannot see you. No?
当你投生成为鬼的时候，你能够看到你的全家人，可是你的家人没有办法看到你。Okay,
so you look at them from the first day until 7 days at home. Okay.
那当时我们会在家里呢，就看着他们从第一天到第七天。
Okay. The first day, they will cry with you, beside you. They may cry, 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 upset, no?
在第一天呢, 他们会在你的身边, 非常难过的在痛哭。
Three or four days later, you from your body, swollen, change the color, and also the smell is come out. Then you could feel the smell from his body or the heart body. No?
那三四天后, 从这个尸体的身上, 这个尸体呢, 开始有点浮肿, 开始改变, 开始发出了这个臭味。
Where they were crying, beside you or a bit distant?
当时他们会在哪里哭呢? 还会在你的身边哭吗? 还是会走远一点去哭呢?
Yeah, slowly with distance, okay. Then slowly, after 7 days, 8 days, the smell is very strong. They don't want to come beside you, no?
那渐渐的在7天或者是8天过后, 这个味道太过强烈了, 他们都不敢要接近你的身体了。
对吗? Yeah, so you can try and really, really love me or not. Only 1 week, okay? So midnight, what you need to do, make it noise. Tong, 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 or walk, okay? Until they can hear. So when they hear about your noise, what they will feel? Oh, my husband is now at home. Are they happy? Are they welcome you or not? They know you are the ghost at home. And you, from you, they know you are at home. Are they really happy? Or not happy with you, no?
那我们到那个时候，我们就可以尝试看看，试探一下他们是不是真正的爱我们。那我们之前在那个时候只是一个星期而已。那在半夜的时候，我们可以就发出一点声音，或者是大声的走动。那当他们听到过后，心里会有什么样的感受呢？会想说啊，我的丈夫在家里。 那他们知道说当时你是鬼，他们是快乐还是不快乐呢？怕
，scared slowly. You will feel scared, even husband and the wife. But you cannot stay at the same bed alone. You are starting to get scared about that kind of sound arise. You know.
当时我们会害怕，虽然说是我们的丈夫或者是我们的妻子，可是我们不敢单独的和这个声音在一起，我们开始害怕。
对吗? Then the next day, what they will do? They quickly will go to the temple and invite Bhante, please come to my house and doing chanting. Now he became a ghost at home. Actually, you are scared, but you didn't want to tell that. You were there. Oh, all the children are scared. So let him go away. You know? You ask Bhante and Supo to chant for him to go away. No?
那隔天呢，他们怎么办呢？他们就会到寺院里面呢去找师傅、找法师，就告诉他说：“我的家里有鬼。”那虽然说是我们自己害怕，可是我们不敢说是我怕。我们说我的孩子害怕。那请你呢，把他请走，就告诉法师，请法师帮忙，
对不对？ Yeah, many people invite me also to do chanting and ask him to go away. I feel sorry for the ghost, you know. That's why I remind all of you not to attach too much before you die, not to attach too much on the other body. No, after die, all have to let go.
所以也有很多人呢邀请禅师到他们的家里去诵经，希望说能够把这些鬼请走。那禅师为这个鬼呢感到很就是难过，所以现在呢想要提醒各位，我们不要太过的执着于他人或者是他人的身体。当我们死后呢，我们都必须要放下。Then
you know, oh, they don't want me to stay at home. They want me to go away. Then you don't have place to stay. Then you will get suffering. No? Then you know that, slowly understand that, oh, what they love me last time, they told me not really true. That is not the true love. Then but too late for you, no? To change.
那到时候呢，我们心里才能够了解到说，原来呢，他们不想要我留在这里，他们想要把我赶走，那我也没有地方去了。在那个时候呢，可能我们就会非常的苦。那这个。 之前他们想说他们非常爱我，可是这是不真实的，他们的爱不是真实的。可是当你发现的时候呢，已经太迟了，已经没有办法再改变你的生命了。
Sorry to say about that, okay?
他就说很抱歉，他要解释这种这些事情。
Not because I want you to break your family. I want you to understand the true, the nature of our body and attachment. No.
那禅师说这些呢，不是想要破坏我们的家庭，主要的是要我们能够了解到真相是什么，还有我们身体的这个真实相。
That's why the Buddha also encouraged that everybody need to practice meditation. Want to make it good karma in this lifetime. If you have good karma and the practice, then only you will go. If you want to go good life, you can go. That karma will support you to get good life, good reward. If you want to get arahant, also will support you to practice and the arahant.
所以佛陀鼓励我们每个人呢，都要禅修，因为禅修能够让我们造下善业。那在这一世，如果说我们造下善业，我们就能够去到一个好的投生，所以这个业能够护持我们得到好的生命。那如果说我们想要努力证得阿罗汉果，这个业也能够护持我们证果的修行。
Who practice until arahant and once returner, they have right understanding very strongly. They also feel that rebirth, life is suffering. They don't want to go many rebirth and around suffering life. Even don't want to come back to the mother wounds. You come back to mother wounds, also suffering. No?
那凡是已经修到证得阿罗汉果，或者是一环果的这个圣者呢，他们有证件，证件他们就能够了解到说，投生生命是苦的，所以他不想要去到很多的这个生命，他连在投入母胎的这个苦呢都不想要承受了。
Do you remember this life, not past life? Okay, this life, how you live in your mother wounds when you are young? No?
那我们能够记得我们的在我们这一生不是过去式，我们这一生呢，我们在母胎的时候的情形是怎么样的呢？
记得吗？ Cannot. That is really no good. Must remember, okay? Then only you have gratitude to your mother. Know how she had to care about you. No?
那我们不记得，那其实这不好。 我们应该要记得，我们才能够呢体会我们对母亲，我们对母亲必须要非常的感恩。We
need concentration mind to look at it day by day and day how you live in the mother wounds. We need to see the picture and the mind.
那当我们有专注力的时候，我们要一天一天的往后看，一直到我们能够看到我们在母胎时候的这个情形和我们当时的心。
Okay, same from the first day you came to the mother wounds and slowly grow. 3 weeks later, from the small ball, become eyes, ear, nose, tongue, body, and happen.
那我们能够看到，我们从母胎的第一天，我们开始呢，一直的在长大，一直到3个星期的时候，我们从一粒小球开始呢，长出了我们的眼耳鼻舌。
Once after a few months, your body started to get clearly appear in the mother wounds.
那几个月过后，我们的身体体型呢，就清楚的能够呈现在母胎里面了。
You can see yourself. You have to squeak. You know, you cannot move. You cannot straighten your leg and your hand. Always need to squeak in very narrow place to stay there.
我们能够看到说，当时的自己呢，我们是挤在里面的，我们不能够动，也不能够把手脚呢伸直，在里面呢是非常窄的一个空间。Okay,
then when you leave it on top of your head, stomach, your mother's stomach, you are under her stomach, the head, you know.
那当我们住在母胎里面的时候，我们的头上就是母亲的胃，我们就。 我们住的地方就在母亲的胃下面。You
can see lower part, you can see all the intestine. You have been sitting on top of the large intestine. Huh?
那在母亲身体的下半部有这个肠子，那我们正坐在母亲的大肠上面。Staying
for how many months?
我们在里面待了几个月呢？
Cannot remember. Someone 10 months, someone 9 months, 8 months. Different people had different conditions. Anyway, whatever you say, the smell is good or not good in the mother wounds, no? every part of the body inside no good smell. You have been staying inside for that for many, many months, many days. You
know? 那我们待在母胎里面，有的人可能十个月，有的人九个月，有的人八个月。那我们住在那个地方里面的这个气味好吗？ 那每个身体里面的每个部位其实发出的这个味道呢是不好的。那我们却在里面呢住了很多个月很多天。So
the mother really took care of you day by day. Whatever he ate the food, the nutrient to transfer to your body.
母亲当时呢一天一天的照顾我们。那凡是他所吃过的食物呢，就会被传送到我们的身体里面去。嗯。
That's why we can say the Buddha has been explaining the rebirth. Rebirth means who start to come to the mother wombs from since the first day, the whole many days, okay? And then 9 months, 10 months, that is we call rebirth. Hmm?
所以当佛陀解释关于投生于母胎的时候，那他所说的意思就是说，我们入母胎的第一天， 一直到很多天后， 一直到九个月、十个月的这段时间。
Man, that is the Buddha explain, that is suffering. That is not a happy feeling, you know, suffering thing, suffering place, to live for a long time. That's why the Buddha explain, who have the river, they are the suffering. Hmm?
那当时呢，佛陀就解释说，这个状况是非常苦的，它不是一种快乐的感受。它这个地方呢，要住在里面，其实也是很苦的。所以佛陀就解释说，只要我们有投生，我们就会有苦。Do
you want to come back again? After you die, do you want to go again in the place?
那我们还想要回来吗？ 在我们死后，我们还想要到那个地方去吗？
Someone don't want, someone stay want.
可能有的人不想要，可能有的人还想要。
Who have attachment for the body, for the human, oh, next life, I want to be a human, I want to be a lady, I want to be a man. That understanding, thinking is wrong view. That's what I explain. Wrong view, no? Ignorance. No?
那凡是说我们对于我们的身体，或者是对这个人生有这个执着，我们会想到说，在下一世我还想要做人，我想做女人，我想做男人，那这是邪见，这是因为无明而升起的邪见。Because
of that wrong view, you want attachment come out for that kind of life, craving and cling on that life, three causes.
因为说我们有这种的邪见，所以我们就对于这种邪见呢有执着，我们执取，我们还我们对我们就有这种执取和贪。Okay,
for the kinds of life, you know that you need good karma, so that's why supporting karma, you will do that, you will do dana, and in this lifetime, now present, okay, you need good karma, so you need to do dana or keep the precept or practice of meditation. That good karma will support you if you want to come back to the human. If you don't have good karma, a lot of bad karma, you cannot come back to the even human. And the worst is heaven. You cannot go worse than human being. No? You need a lot of good karma.
如果说想要得到这种生命，我们也必须要有善业。那我们怎么做呢？我们行布施在这一世，或者是我们造善业，我们通过布施、持戒或者是禅修，让我们能够得到人的这个生命。如果说我们没有善业，造下了很多的恶业，那我们没有办法投生成为人，更何况呢，没有办法成为这个天人。所以我们需要很多的善业。That's
when people understand what the cause and effect. When you want to get the effect is good, you need the cause, need to do good things and good karma. Many people know, many Buddhists know about that. That's why we are training to get good karma. And also not only that, you really scared about the human or the deva or the kind of river, the one, the person will practice vipassana until you can get until enlightened, until you get an arahant. Who have become arahant mind, they will never come back again, never suffer, no need to be suffer again and again, no need to get rebirth.
所以当我们能够了解到这个因果关系的话，我们就能够知道说，当我们要有很好的这个果报，我们就要有这个好的因，我们必须要有这个善业。那很多佛教徒都了解这个道理，所以我们训练让自己呢能够造下很多的善业。 那到最后呢，如果说呢，我们其实我们也会害怕这个人的生命，或者是天人的生命。当我们练习观禅的时候，最后我们能够证果，我们能够成为阿罗汉果。那凡是证得阿罗汉果的人呢，不会再回来，不会再受苦了，也不会再投生了。And
also the nature of our life, also you can see, since you came out from the mother wombs, you have suffered. You need to associate with external, the hot, cold, the kind of feeling, very suffering for you the first day.
那我们生命的性质也能够从这个母胎看到，就是从第一天，当我们第一次出母胎的时候，我们就开始受苦，就会突然间感觉到冷和热的这个感觉，这是很苦的。As
soon as you come out from the mother wombs, you have been crying or smiling and happy, laughing. The feeling that, no?
当我们第一次出母胎的时候，我们是哭着出来还是笑着出来的呢？当时是什么样的感受？
Do you remember or not?
记得吗？
Cannot remember. Except Buddha, many people have been crying, scared. That is the sign of life. Started the first moment already crying. Start by crying, no?
那除了佛陀以外，每个人呢都是哭着出来的，因为我们害怕。那这个就是我们生命的一种象征，这个就是我们生命的第一课。The
last day, rebirth, aging, you know, and death. That is the nature of our life. Who have the rebirth, the person will get aging and will get sick one day, will die. This is the nature no one can avoid. So before you die, you will have that problem just now with the expanded dependent origination. Now I have been explaining. No? So you don't want to associate with dislike people. You don't want to strip respect from your family. That is when you know that nearly die moment, I have to separate. That is suffering, pain. A lot of pain will happen. That is what we call the nature of our dependent origination. No?
然后到我们生命的最后一天的时候，那凡是有投生呢，就有老有死，这是我们生命的一种性质。那当我们投生了，我们会老，我们会生病，我们会死。那我们死之前呢，我们会有这个，好像之前解释过的这个问题，所以这个是一个缘起。那我们呢，不喜欢呢和我们自己。 我们自己讨厌的人在一起，也不想要和我们的家人分开，所以当我们必须要被分开的时候，我们就感觉非常的痛苦。那这个呢，就是缘起的这个性质。That's
why we need to practice vipassana again for that dependent origination also. And in the end, you know that right understanding all are impermanence. Okay, rebirth also impermanence. Which kind of life you want? Every kind of life also will come and go. One day will disappear.
所以当我们呢，就是修缘起法、修观禅的时候，到最后我们能够升起这个正见，能够看到所有的现象都是无常的，这个身也是无常的。那所有的生命，它都会来来去去，到最后呢也会消失。
Understand or not? So now present is very important for your future. You need to choose. No?
那我们明白吗？所以我们的现在是很重要。为我们的未来呢，我们必须要做出抉择。Understand?
You want to be an arahant, totally don't want suffering anymore, or still want to come back again and again, with suffering continuously. And if you don't want to clear your mind and karma, still, you have to go down and suffer again and again in the lower beings also. No? If you want the kind of suffering, you will do continuously bad things, break the precept. Who are scared, don't want to go to the hell being, don't want to get suffering life, the person start to realize that, oh, I don't want to suffer there. I want, at least I want to get good life. So the kind of people, we need to take care of our mind and our practice to be good and to get a lot of good karma. In the present. Now, if you don't take care, no time for you to get collect good karma, too late. The last moment before you die, only you want to make a good karma, too late. You cannot meditate, you cannot get many good things, that will be dangerous. No? So now, please mindfully practice in your life to be good, to train, to be good. No?
所以我们必须要决定说，我想要证得阿罗汉果吗？ 就是我不想要再有苦了吗？ 或者是我还想要再来，我还想要来受苦？ 那如果说我们不照顾好自己的心和业， 那我们必须要往下，往一些，往恶去， 去继续受苦。 那如果说呢， 我们觉得说这个很苦， 那我们还有做坏事， 我们不觉得苦的话， 我们会做坏事， 我们会破戒。 可是如果说我们害怕， 说我们不想要到恶道去， 我们开始发觉说呢， 我不想要苦， 我想要得到好的生命， 那个时候我们才会照顾好我们的心和我们的修行， 让我们尽量的能够造下善业。 要不然呢， 我们已经没有时间造下这个善业了。 如果等到在临死的时候， 我们才想造善业， 已经太迟了， 在那个时候是很危险的。 所以现在呢， 我们就要非常有正念的修行， 来训练我们呢， 累积这些善业。
Okay. Can you accept it or not?
你能够接受这个吗？
Understand not?
明白吗？
But answering is very soft.
就回答的声音很小哦。
This is important for our life, okay? We really need to take care, we really need to protect. So that's why every day, from the morning until evening, we need to take care, you need to guide by the mindfulness to your mind.
You know? 所以我们必须要照顾我们必须要保护我们的心每一天呢， 从早上到晚上， 我们都必须要用正念来保护着我们的心。
Trying to do more metta every day, send metta loving kindness to yourself, to others.
那我们应该尝试散播慈心， 散播给我们自己和他人。
Okay, not to get so many desire, greed. Too much desire come, you're trying to contemplate and they say, oh, one day I have to die. When I die, I have to let go of my body, I have to let go of my family, I have to let go of all whatever I have, all the properties. You cannot bring with you. So that's why I have to attach too much. You know? That's kind of understanding, need to contemplate and cut attachment. You know?
所以呢，我们也不要升起太多的贪，太多的欲望。当我们的欲望太多的时候，我们可以做这样的一个思维，想说有一天我也必须要死。那我死后呢，我也必须要放下我的家人、我的身体和我的财产。那我没有办法带着走。那为什么我现在还要执着呢？当我们做这样的一个思维的话，我们就能够断除执着。Once
you can let go of slowly of attachment in your mind, you trying to check yourself. Less desire, you have not much thing what you want, not much, then you can feel the mind more stable, more peaceful. You want this, when there's so many things you want, the mind not peaceful. And also you need to work hard and you need to get more money for that desire, no?
所以我们慢慢的，当我们能够放下的话呢， 那我们的心里面呢， 会变得欲望减少了。 当我们的欲望不多的时候， 我们的心呢， 会变得更加的稳定， 更加的平静。 如果说我们想要的东西很多， 我们的内心没有办法平静， 而且我们要非常努力的工作， 才能得到这些东西。
Okay, anger also dangerous, angry, no? Also need to control. If you practice a lot of metta, loving kindness, the person not easy to get angry mind. If not, you don't know how to take care of your mind, the mind is free, easily will get angry, whatever you contact. No?
还有就是这个嗔心，这个嗔心是很危险的，我们必须要控制自己的心。如果说一个人呢，常常练习慈心，那他不容易生气。那我们的心，如果说我们不照顾好的，那他就很，当我们的心有空的话，他也很容易的生气。
So you can check every day in the past, as soon as you wake up early in the morning, what kinds of mind is mostly happening to you? Wholesome, metta, or easily get angry, not happy with everybody, you know?
那我们每一天都可以检查自己，当我一起生的时候，我是要带着什么样的心呢？ 我是带着善心吗？ 我是带着慈心吗？ 还是嗔心， 就是对很多人， 对每个人都感到不满意呢？
Please answer. Your time to answer now.
请回答， 现在轮到你们回答了。
Don't pretend, okay?
也不用假装了。
You wake up with metta or with anger?
当我们起身的时候是带着慈心还是带着嗔心呢？
慈心哦，萨杜萨杜萨 very good. I'm happy to hear about that, you know.
那有的人回答说是带着慈心，那很好，禅师非常随喜，很快乐能够听到这个答复。
Okay, everybody trying to wake up with metta. This is good for your karma and your body also. Wake up, peaceful.
所以每一个人呢，希望说我们都能够带着慈心起身，这对我们的业和对我们的身体都有好处。
Who wake up with anger, no good for your karma and no good for your body also.
那凡是带着嗔心起身的人呢，这对我们的业没有好处，对我们的身体也没有好处。
好不好 ？So for this one day of retreat, I want all of you to practice meditation every day. Everybody, I want all of you to wake up with metta. This is our present for you.
那在 这一次的一日禅修营当中，禅师希望说每个人呢可以每一天的都禅修，希望每一个人可以每一天的带着慈心而起身，这是禅师呢送给各位的礼物。
萨杜萨杜萨杜
Thank you very much to everybody again and also to the Vashi and all the organizer and all the volunteerAnd all the donors and all the meditators, I wish all of you to be happy and healthy and can attend to Nirvana in this lifetime.
禅师非常的感谢所有的人，所有的法师，所有的义工，所有的布施者和所有的禅修者，祝愿每个人都能够快乐健康，都能够证入涅槃。
I will get some blessing for all of you too.
现在禅师想要为大家呢念诵这个祝福经。
Yen doni metam awa minglincha yocha manapo saguna sasaro papregoho dusupina kena buddha nubawina winansamintu dhamma nubawina winansamintuSangha nubhavena vinansamintu Dukha patta sannidokha Beya patta sannibeya Sokha patta sannisokha Sahasabihi nyatipi Itawata chamihi Sabaram punya sabaram Sabidiwa anumodanu Sabasabadi sediya Dhanandararu sadara Sinurakantu sabada Pavana Vyata Hontu Kesantu Devatagara Sabe Bauda Blapata Pichika Ninchayam Brahm Arata Ninchya Dejena Rakam Brani Savaso Yang Genchi Vidam Idawa Hurawa Sage Suwa Yayadanam Pnita Nano Sama Ati Tathagrena Irami Bodhiranam Pita Itena Tisena Thuvati Hontu Yang Genchi Vidam Idawa Hurawa Sage Suwa Yang Yadanam Pita Nano Sama Ati Tathagrena Irami Dhammiranam Pita Itena Tisena Thuvati HontuYang Genchi Vida Idawa Hurawa Sage Suwa Yang Yadana Prita Nano Sama Ati Tathagrena Idami Sangirana Prita Itena Tisena Thuvati Hontu Pavantu Sabha Mingla Rakhantu Sabha Divata Sabha Bodha Nubhavena Sada Sukhen Pavantu TeBhavantu sabha mingra rakhantu sabha divata Sabha dhamma nubhavena sada sukhen bhavantu te Bhavantu sabha mingra rakhantu sabha divata Sabha sangha nubhavena sada sukhen bhavantu te Maha karunika natha hitara sabha parinna Puritva parami sabha patho smati mautamaSiyanta Bodhya Muli Sajjana Nanti Watano Iwa Miwa Siyan Hontu Siyatu Siyan Melengri Aprajita Pringe Suse Bhutto Vipokli Bisege Sabha Bhutana Ega Pratho Pamodasi Sunakatam, Sumingalam, Subhabhatam, Suhotaitam, Sukhano, Sumoho, Tosa, Suritam, Brahmacharisu, Brekinam, Kayakama, Wachakama, Brekinam, Brekinam, Manokama, Bridite, Brekine, Brekita, Nikatwa, Labantite, Brekine, De Atta, Lata, Wiyuta, Buddha, Sasane, Aroga, Sukhita, Hota, Saha, Sabihi, Nyatibi. May all of you be free from dangers, free from mental suffering, free from physical suffering. May all of you be well, happy, and attend to the Nibbana.
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Sadhu.